what other people have viewed as like, oh, you're the weakest link. I just was like, I'm just gonna go crazy and run on the internet, and then before you know it, it's all about the internet. And so where you have a lot of companies trying to figure out the internet is all I've known professionally. So then I got the idea for CurlBox and I launched that about 5 years ago.
That you gained from your PR career that you use in CurlBox currently?
Absolutely. I think that if you want to be an entrepreneur, the best thing to do is look at who are some companies that you think are doing it right. And the best thing that you can do is go work for them. I think so many people, they want to jump out there and become an entrepreneur and think, you know, do it overnight. The fastest way for you to learn is to, you fast track yourself by figuring out who's doing it right. And so that was really what I wanted to do, was that I wanted to go learn from the companies who are doing it really well. And that is really where I learned. My first job is where I learned my pace. So I think a lot of people don't understand that entrepreneurship is a fast pace and you have to learn it. And I think it's uncomfortable at first. And it's just this thing of like, imagine, I always say, it was like, I got the job and I was juggling like 5 balls at a time. And that in and of itself is like, okay, I'm juggling 5 balls. And every 15 minutes.
Essentially, entrepreneurship is definitely a leap of faith. So, you know, you always need a strong team behind you to support that movement in entrepreneurship. So are there any mentors that you have that have helped you in that transition to make it smoother?
Yeah, I mean, I have friends who are entrepreneurs, and I think by having friends with people who have already done it made me feel like it wasn't that difficult, you know? So it's like, this is my best friend's an entrepreneur, and I'm like, oh, well, he can do it. Then I definitely can do it. But
elaborate on what that means.
Absolutely. I think that it's very easy to look at what someone else is doing and go, I can do that too. Or maybe I can do that better. But I think that you have to say, where are the gaps? What is missing and where can I add value? And I think that the reason why I started my company is that I felt like I did a lot of reading and I heard about sampling, making a resurgence. Like before it hit the surface of like, you know, public news, or was it tech news? And I was like, this is a good idea, just not the right market, because how often have we gone shopping and all the samples are like not in your color, like not for you? There's always samples for other people, but there's never samples for us. And so that was my thing of like, how can I provide what's missing?